A very good morning to all of you. Myself Shilajit Ghosh, the faculty member of IHM Kolkata. Today I am going to take the second session on the topic sandwich. In this particular session, I would like to discuss the types of sandwich, making of sandwich, stoning of sandwich. But before I start the topic of the day, I will just try to recap the previous session. In the previous session, I have discussed the brief history about the sandwiches, the definition of sandwich, different components of sandwich, and the types of bread, types of spread, varieties of filling and garnishes which has been used for making of the various sandwiches. Now, to recap with all, now we start the second session. In the second session, I will just start with the various category of sandwiches which has been nowadays is very popular. Sandwiches are basically classified into two categories. One is cold and another one is hot, depending on the basis of method of preparation and serving temperature. Let's discuss the detail of each type. First, we start with the cold sandwich. As the name suggests, cold means the sandwich are served cold or at room temperature. The various types of sandwiches are in the cold category. First one is conventional sandwich, second one is tea sandwich, third one is buffet sandwich, fourth one is continental sandwich, fifth one is open sandwich, and the last one is fancy sandwich. So first start with the detail of conventional sandwich. It also known as closed sandwich or lunch box sandwich. They are the traditional sandwich in which the two slices of white or brown bread filled with different types of filling with spreads and garnishes. Then the sandwiches are cut into neat triangle diagonally and served to the guest with or without crust depends on the basis of standard to be followed by the organization. The sandwich also known as lunchbox sandwich because the sandwich is a wholesome meal, so people can have the sandwich in the time of lunch. Also, and it is a nicely fitted into the lunchbox very conveniently. So that is why the another name of this conventional sandwich is lunchbox sandwich. The second one is tea sandwich. These are similar like conventional sandwich, but the basic difference in the terms of size. In this category, the sandwiches are cut into smaller triangles or into finger shape with very light filling, without crust, with proper eye appealing garnishes, and it will be served in the time of high tea or maybe in the time of afternoon. The next category is buffet sandwich. This is a similar kind of sandwich like conventional sandwich, but the basic difference is in terms of shape. In this variety, the sandwiches are cut into fancy shape like heart, diamond, oval, triangle, square with the help of different shape of sandwich cutter. It will serve in the time of tea time in the banquet party and it will be served in a large platter or in a miniature form. But there will be a lot of wastage due to the reason of trimmings of this variety. So please take care when you are applying this kind of sandwich for the buffet, so when the cost permit. Next one is the continental or French sandwich. This variety of sandwiches are made with the famous crusty French bread or known as French baguettes. The whole bread slit into half horizontal and then smeared with the butter and filled with different variety of savory filling. It can be served whole or cut into half for easy handling of French sandwich. When the sandwich served whole, then the sandwich known as foot long. In America, this variety of sandwich is also known as submarine sandwich. The next category is open sandwich, one of the most popular and eye-appealing sandwich in the world. As per definition, open sandwich is not technically a sandwich, but sandwich needs at least a two slices of bread, but for convenience, they are classified as sandwich. If the top bread is missing, what we call a half sandwich or a garnished pieces of bread, so better name was found, that is open sandwich. Open sandwich are made with slices of butter spread on top of that with different kind of filling. Since the sandwich served open, it is very important that filling supposed to be very neatly arranged with a proper garnish, and the garnish supposed to be with prime quality so that it's look more attractive and eye appealing. The bread may be white or brown, toasted or plain when you are preparing this kind of sandwiches. It should not be confused with the canapé, because canapé made with different base, but open sandwich always made with the bread base. That is a small difference. When you talking about the canapés, all the different kind of breads, different kind of cookies, biscuits are can be used. But in particularly for sandwiches, only the bread will be used. So that is the basic difference. Open sandwiches are made not only for the purpose of eye appealing, it might be satisfy the palate of the guest also. In the cold sandwich category, the another one is fancy sandwiches. These are the variety of fancy sandwiches which look good when put on an exhibition and display, and they add a new dimension in the cold buffet. There are the few examples of fancy sandwich which very popular nowadays in the hospitality world. The first one is ribbon sandwich, second one is mosaic sandwich, third one is pinwheel sandwich, fourth one is checkerboard sandwich, and the last one is rolled sandwich. I'll just give you a small detail about all varieties of fancy sandwiches. The first start with ribbon sandwich. This sandwich are made by layering of white or brown slices of bread with colorful filling until a square block is obtained. The block is kept in the fridge and chilled down, and then after it cut into 1 cm thick slices so that it will be very neat and tidy. Next one is mosaic sandwich. This is the variety of fancy sandwich which look very attractive and very nice for display. It will give a new dimension in the cold buffet presentation. The third one is pinwheel sandwich. This type of sandwich made in the process of rolling. The long slice of bread smeared with spread and filled with filling and roll into 5 to 6 cm diameter. Then it will be sliced into 1 cm thick and served cold and arranged in a proper way so that it look very nice. The next fancy sandwich is checkerboard sandwich, a type of sandwich which is made with many square of alternate color of bread. It may be brown, it may be white. It is also be served in the time of high tea. And the last one is roll sandwich. This kind of sandwich prepared with large pieces of bread which needs to be spread with butter and filled with required filling and rolled it very tightly and wrapped with a clean wrap and kept it at least for 1 hour inside the fridge so that it should not be loosen while you serve to the guest. It will be served cold with the side trim condition for better presentation. So these are the all varieties of fancy sandwich. Now we start with the hot sandwich. The hot sandwiches are prepared and served hot, and the method of preparation are grilling and toasting. So on the basis of that, the sandwiches are divided into two category. One is grilled sandwich and another one is toasted sandwich. So in the grilled sandwich category, we have few more examples. The first one is the burger, second one is the panini, third one is the croque monsieur or madame. It is originated from France. Next one is the grilled ham and cheese sandwich. Next one is hot dog, and the last one Stammermax. It is originated from Germany. Now we'll discuss each of the category in detail. The first one is burger. Burger is one of the most famous sandwich and everybody I think know about it, but I'll just give you a small detail so that it will be specific and it will be easier for you to remember. The first burger bun which has been cut into halves and which has been toasted or maybe grilled and which has been filled with a grilled patty topped with tomato, onion, cheese. A patty may be non-veg, a patty may be veg. If we are using the non-veg patty like chicken, it's become chicken burger. If it's become veg, it's become veg burger. So on the basis of the patty you are using in the burger, the name of the burger denotes. And it will be served with french fries, various kind of tossed salad with the accompaniment of mustard sauce or maybe tartar sauce. The next is panini. It's one of the most important and very famous sandwich in Italy. It is originated from Italy and made with focaccia bread. It's one of the most popular bread in the country. It has been filled with cheese, ham, salami, mortadella, and different kind of filling can be used. And it will be served with grill or in the form of toasted. So it depends on the choice of the guest. The next category is croque monsieur. it's a sandwich from France and a slice of ham between two slices of cheese enclosed between two slices of bread, and it will be grilled or pan fried till cheese are melted and the sandwich become golden in color. Then it has been cut into triangles and served with French fries, one of the most popular sandwich in the country France. Next one is grilled and ham and cheese. It's an old time favorite sandwich with a Pullman bread. A slice of ham and a slice of cheese, maybe in the form of Emmental and Gruyere, the variety, which has been enclosed between two slices of bread, and it will be made with grill till the cheese has been melted down properly and it should be golden in color. Then it will be cut into triangles and served with a French fries, tartar sauce or the specialty pickled vegetables. So these are the examples of accompaniments. The next is hot dog sandwich. The hot dog is also very popular nowadays and it's a very convenient sandwich for rush hour time. Hot dog bun is split into two with one sided attached so that the filling should not be fall down very easily. The filled with varieties of chicken sausages, especially the Frankfurter sausages with lettuce and mustard, and it will be served hot and it will be very delighted to everyone when you are in a rush time because you can conveniently carry the sandwich very well. The next category is Stammermuchs. The Stammermuchs sandwich is very popular and it is a kind of open sandwich. One slice of bread grilled or pan fried with butter, and you have used the sauteed lardoons of bacon placed on top with single fried egg and garnished with watercress or maybe any varieties of fresh herbs. In the hot sandwich category, you have divided into grilled and toasted. Under the toasted sandwich category, you have again divided into three. First is club sandwich, bookmaker sandwich and Denver sandwich. Now we start detailing about the club sandwich. Club sandwich is one of the most popular sandwich in the world, and it will be made with Pullman loaf, and it will be maybe made with the three slices of bread with two varieties of filling, and when you serve to the guests, the crust needs to be removed, and it always served with coleslaw or French fries. But the beauty of the sandwich is that the one variety of filling supposed to be veg and one variety of filling supposed to be non-veg. The next is bookmaker sandwich, where the two slices of toasted white bread has been filled with grilled mignon steak placed and topped with mustard paste, and sandwich are pressed between two metal plates still the steak supposed to be very juicy and all. Next, Denver sandwich. It is one of the most popular sandwich. Two slices of toasted bread are smeared with butter. The first slice is topped with chicken liver pate and topped with smoked salmon or ham or sauteed onion, and this sandwich has been reheated the sandwich again till the crust has been nicely done and it can be served without crust. Next, the making process of sandwich. So while we are talking about the making process, there should be a hygiene factor. So when you start the making of the sandwich, hygiene is one of the most important factor, and always handle the sandwich with a care. So always handle the sandwich with the wearing a gloves. So there are few guidelines when you are preparing the sandwiches. The first guideline with the bread, second one is the spread, third one is the filling, and fourth one is the garnishes. So while you choosing the making the sandwiches, you should be very careful about these four components. Just I'll just give you a small guideline about the bread. First one is, it should be advised that if you are using the fish filling, use the brown bread. So it will be easier and the bread will soak the moisture very well. Next one is, if you are using the meat, then use the white bread. That is the basic guideline. Bread needs to be toasted in a toaster or salamander for making of toasted sandwich and for even distribution of the toasting process. Third one is, use 1 day old bread for toasted sandwich. Next is, for plain sandwich, always use a fresh bread. And last, the bread supposed to be firm and not too moist. So when you spread on the bread, it should not be tear the bread. Next is, it should cover the bread including the corner part. Next is, always use fresh spread. Do not keep it for long. The spread supposed to be prepared just before the sandwich will make. The next is flavor of spread should be complement the filling. So whenever you're talking about the spread, it should complement the main filling of the sandwiches. Next guideline for filling. Filling should be fresh in nature, handled with proper hygiene, should not touch with the bare hand. It should be evenly spread on the bread and avoid very strong flavor in the filling. Next is the guideline for the garnish. The garnish guidelines are, garnish should be edible in nature, so that whatever the garnish has been given on the sandwich, it should be edible by the customer or guest. Next is, garnish needs to be fresh and crisp, so that the eye appealing part will be more. The third one is, garnish should be complement the sandwich. And the last one is, it increases the color contrast of the sandwich, which is responsible to increase the eye appealing of the guest.